time WDSU first warning weather. You can see all alerts impacts have gone away, but we will have another impact day to come because what we had today has the potential to come into Friday, through the weekend, next week, maybe even the following week. Listen, this is a fairly simple forecast from my perspective. For you, it could mean a lot. Rain trend forecast, rainfall trend forecast over the next 5 days. I mean, it is a good bet. Highly likely you're going to run into a storm at some point each and every day, Friday through the weekend, going into next week. You could put that in all the way through next week to the weekend. For one thing, and the good thing is it brings temperatures down. We've broken that heat of that last heat wave we've got. But to sum it up, storms at some point each day, locally heavy rain, the flood threat, just what we went through on Thursday afternoon. Temperatures dependent when those storms fire. So if the storms fire earlier, if we have storms in the morning hours up till midday, that gets a lot of the heating out of the way and we stay a bit cooler. If we get those storms a little bit later, we get more sun, then we can be hotter. That's really the rule of thumb here, 80s to 91. This front, a little cooler air, we don't get it. But then the enhancement of a little spinning system here from previous storms elsewhere in the U.S. that created its own kind of system and spin, well, that's helping to enhance the rain chances, what we did today. Now, overnight hours, there is a shot we developed some isolated showers or storms. And then it's 70s to wake up and get going as we go into Friday morning and get out the door. But there is a chance of showers and storms by the time we get up. So I say give yourself a few extra minutes. Tune on here, WDSU News, 4, 5, 6 in the morning here. And we're looking at 70-degree temps and the chance of rain. Meteorologist Damon Singleton in traffic with Deja will take you through. So storms look a bit likelier in the morning hours on Friday, and that should hold temperatures down. We get them out by the afternoon, but there could be some isolated, widely scattered showers in the nighttime hours. And with every single round of these storms, there's a flood risk. It's a very low level, level 1 out of 4, or a slight risk, we call it. But I'm going to take those top temps down to only 87 here in New Orleans. Of course, you factor in the humidity, and it's still hotter than that. But really, it's nothing like what we had 94, 95, feeling 110, 113. So we go into Friday's forecast. There's a look at Friday night into Saturday. And there's a chance of storms even into Saturday morning up till midday, but widely scattered storms shown. I think that's really underdone. I've got more storm activity, the chance of locally heavy rain and flooding, and I still have high temps to the upper 80s. And this forecast just continues to go in through the weekend and next week. And this system, one that lives a couple miles up in the air at the jet stream level, interacting with the leftover fronts, still keeps us under a flood risk for Sunday, for Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday next week. It almost sounds like I'm doing a happy days dance here. And that's just the storms that will continue each and every day. So be prepared. Now, if there's even better news in the forecast, though, is we still have not seen any development and potential over the next 7 days, the Atlantic, the Caribbean, or the Gulf. I have seen a long-term forecast that was just updated on Thursday going into early August that shows there might be some potential. It's still a ways away. WDSU first warning weather, 7-day forecast, impact day tomorrow for storms, and storms will continue through the weekend to next week. Be prepared for rain and watch out for that flood risk.